हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय गोपी जन बल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, जय गोपी जन बल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, जय दशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, दशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तेरा बनचारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय श्री प्रभुपाद की, हरिनाम संकीर्तन की, समवेत भक्त वृंद की, ताई गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि वो। भागवतम पार्ट वन don't have canto, cannot canto one, canto 10 part 1 you have or you don't have, that we can read one verse something related to Krishna's appearance. Kaun sa verse hai malum Radharaman Maharaj? Krishna appearance verse, advent of Lord Krishna. ॐ अज्ञानतमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदामयं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगना रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगनललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च वंशाकल्पतरुभश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु
दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि श्री गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। नारायणं नमस्कृतं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जय मुदीरयेत् मुखं करोति वासलं पङ्गुलं हयतगिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे परमानन्द माधवं श्रीगुरुदिनतारिणं श्रीचैतन्यईश्वरम्। सो टुडे इज मोस्ट ऑस्पिशियस अपीयरेंस डे ऑफ लॉर्ड श्री कृष्ण। Second read. So in this regard, we just read one verse from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 2. Then we will discuss about Krishna's appearance. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। भगवान् अपि विश्वात्मा भक्तानां अभयंकर आविविषय अंशभागेन मन आनक दुंदुहे। Thus the supreme personality of Godhead, who is the super soul of all living entities and who vanquishes all the fear of his devotees, entered the mind of Vasudeva in full opulence. Purport. The word Vishwatma refers to one who is situated in everyone's heart. Ishwara Sarvabhutanam Hridyase Arjuna Tishtati. Another meaning of Vishwatma is the only lovable object of everyone. Because of forgetfulness of this object, people are suffering in this material world. But if one fortunately revives his old consciousness of loving Krishna and connects with Vishwatma, one becomes perfect. The Lord is described in the third canto as follows: Parabareso mahat ansa iktohi ajopi jata bhagavan. Although unborn, the Lord, the master of everything, appears like a born child by entering the mind of a devotee. The Lord is already there within the mind, and consequently it is not astonishing for him to appear as if born from a devotee's body. The word abhivesha signifies that the Lord appeared within the mind of Vasudeva. There is no need for a discharge of semen. That is the opinion of Sripad Sridhar Swami and Srila Vishwanath Chakrabarti Thakur. In the Vaishnava Toshani, Srila Sanatana Goswami says that consciousness was awakened within the mind of Vasudeva. Srila Viraraghava Acharya also says that Vasudeva was one of the demigods, that within his mind the Supreme Personality of Godhead appeared as an awakening consciousness. End of the purport by Srila Prabhupada. So here it has been mentioned Bhagavan Api, and also Prabhupada quoting a verse, Ajapi Jata Bhagavan, So Bhagavan is Aja. Aja means Parambrahma Bhagavan is he who never takes birth. Then how to understand? That is the reason why the opposite groups, they bring this argument that because the criteria Parambrahma Bhagavan is Aja, he never takes birth, but Krishna has taken birth, Rama has taken birth, then how can they become Bhagavan or Parambrahma? So in answer to this, Prabhupada is saying, wherever Shastra says that Bhagavan is Aja, unborn, that refers to spiritual world. In Golok Vrindavan, Krishna never took birth. There was not a day that he was not existing, and Yashoda, Mother Yashoda, gave birth to Krishna. Nanda, Yashoda, Devaki, Vasudev, who are the transformation of his Sandhini Shakti, one who holds Krishna, his ever-existential potency, that manifests personification of that ever-existential Sandhini Shakti, that manifests as father and mother of Krishna eternally. So spiritual world, Nanda, Yashoda, Devaki, Vasudev, eternally they are there, and Krishna also eternally there, he is there. This Aja word refers to that spiritual world where he never takes birth. Then here it has mentioned Aja api jata Bhagavan. That's why it has been stated Aja api, even if he is unborn. So he has taken birth. How to understand this? For understanding any subject matter, there are two kinds of understanding, two kinds of consideration. One is apata vichar and another is tattva vichar. Apata vichar means by your common sense, just what you see, you come to a conclusion. You consider on that basis. That is apata vichar. Tattva vichar means you find the truth behind the subject matter. What are the internal reasons, causes? That is called tattva vichara. That is reason why in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is saying, janma karma cha me divyam evam jobeti tattvatah. You have to understand in truth, not what you see in your naked or in ordinary eyes. Janma karma cha me divyam. To understand janma karma, birth and activities of Krishna is so important, is so great, that just by understanding this, janma karma cha me divyam evam jobeti tattvatah tektva deham punarjanmam. Once you leave this body, you never take birth again. You go back to Godhead. So to understand the birth and activities of Krishna means to understand the transcendental nature of his birth and activities. Janma karma chame divyam. Divyam means transcendental. Transcendental means the transcendental to three modes of material nature. So on this appearance day, we will discuss on some informative subjects related to Lord Krishna's appearance. So first we have to understand what is his appearance, what does this mean, appearance? When he appears, why he appears, what are the preparations that Krishna takes in spiritual world, what are the causes in the material world, what are the causes in the spiritual world? So there are many things related that our great acharyas, they have described very nicely in different scriptures, so that we can have a overall idea
about the appearance of Lord Krishna, of a clear idea about the appearance of Lord Krishna. So in this regard, to understand the transcendental nature of appearance of Krishna, first we have to understand that there are two kinds of pastimes of Krishna or God. One is called prakat lila, another is called aprakat lila. So aprakat lila means that transcendental sweet pastimes eternally going on in the spiritual world. That is aprakat lila. And prakat lila means when that transcendental pastimes is visible to the people in general in this material world. Prakat lila. So Krishna janma, Krishna's birth is not like the birth of any human being or any demigods or any Mahapurusha, not like that. His birth is very special, as Prabhupada has said. Any of us who take birth, then we have no hair on our head. How we take birth and how Krishna took birth? Long hair, nice dress, necklace, helmets, that itself proves. Common people should just at least understand on this basis the how Krishna's appearance is transcendental. Then to understand about his appearance. What is his appearance? Actually, he is eternally existing. His pastimes eternally going on. But as it has been stated in Bhagavad Gita, Naham Prakasa Sarvasa Yogamaya Samabritam. Yogamaya cotton covers him that people cannot see, but behind the cotton always is existing. So when that cotton opens, Sambhavami Atmamaya, these two verses clarifies. The one verse says, Yogamaya Samabritam. Yogamaya has covered me. So when that Yogamaya unveils, Sambhavami Atmamaya, by the help of my Yogamaya, I manifest myself to everybody. And the same word has been used there also. Aja api san abhayatma. Just like here, aja api jata bhagavan. That unborn bhagavan has taken birth, janama. Same way Bhagavad Gita also describes, aja api san abhayatma bhutanang ishwar api san Prakritim swam adhisthaya sambhavami atmaya. Ajapisan abhayatma, even if he is unborn, he manages prakritim swam adhisthaya, by swapakriti, by his own nature, he reveals himself. So this is the way that we should understand the transcendental nature of the appearance of Krishna, not in some materialistic way, thinking. Just like in India, sometimes people they ask that why ISKCON people chanting Hare Krishna first, then Hare Rama? Rama came first, Tritiya Yuga, so we should have chanted Rama first, Krishna came Dwapara Yuga, then Krishna afterwards. But they don't understand this Rama, Krishna eternally existing. Not first, second coming. There are eternally sweet pastimes going on in their respective abodes, planets. So that is the transcendent nature of the appearance. And appearance in this material world, also there are two kinds of appearance. Just like I explained, two kinds of pastimes, aprakat lila, prakat lila. Same way there are two kinds of appearance also. One is called advaraka appearance, another is Sadvaraka appearance. Advaraka appearance means Krishna appears without help of father mother. No father mother business. He just appears. How he can appear? He can appear from anywhere because he is existing everywhere in the form of Paramatma. As Prabhupada has said, Krishna is not necessary to come and enter into the mind of Vasudeva. Krishna is there, just like fire, the wood, Fire is everywhere in the wood. You cannot see it. But fire is there. Same Krishna is there everywhere. But he becomes visible but under certain conditions. He manifested from Vasudeva. That's why his name is Vasudeva, Vasudeva Krishna. So what is the principle behind it? Sattvam Visuddham Vasudeva Sabditam. Try to understand this explanation. Bhagavata explains about the secret of Krishna's appearance. The interesting part of Krishna's appearance. Sattvam Visuddham Vasudeva Sabditam. Sattva Vasudeva. Vasudeva word means Visuddha Sattva. That is tamaguna, rajaguna, sattvaguna. When you are in tamaguna, sattvaguna, rajaguna, you cannot see Krishna. But visuddha sattva, then Krishna manifests. So vasudeva sattva, word means visuddha sattva, transcendental to three modes of material nature. So Prabhupada pointing out that because anywhere there is Visuddha Sattva, then Bhagavan will manifest. The apabritam, he uncovers. So that's why Sattam Visuddham Vasudeva Sabditam. The Vasudeva means that is the area where, that is the time when one free from mode of material nature, then Krishna will manifest. That's why it is transcendental to three modes of material nature. And Adwaraka appearance, that Krishna appears without the help of father mother. When Krishna appeared without the help of father mother, which incarnation? In which incarnation God came? Narasimha Dev Jai Jai, Sri Radha Nilmadhava Ki Jai. Narasimha Bhagavan, no father mother. Any other incarnation, no father mother? Varaha. Any other incarnation? Any other incarnation? Kurma. All they from Matsya incarnation, Kurma incarnation, Varaha incarnation, then came Narasimha incarnation. Lord came without father mother. Must incarnation just appeared from the water of Satyavrata Muni or kings. Barhadav just appeared from the nose. Narasimha Dev appeared from the pillar. So no father, mother. But what happens in this incarnation? After Narasimha Bhagavan killed Prahlad Maharaj, so he placed Prahlad Maharaj on his lap. He's embracing, kissing, licking, so nice. He's getting, enjoying the Vatsalya, putting a baby on his lap, putting a boy on his lap. Then Narasimha Bhagavan thought that I am enjoying so much by putting this boy on my lap, embracing, kissing. But what kind of enjoyment this boy is deriving by sitting on my lap? That Bhagavan doesn't know because he has no father, mother. So he doesn't know that. Then he decided, I must come with father, mother. Otherwise, how I'll understand? How Prahlad is enjoying sitting on my lap, so if I have father, mother, so I can sit on the lap of my father, mother, and I understand what these fellows are enjoying. They're deriving what kind of enjoyment. So next incarnation, he came with the help of father, mother. What incarnation is that? That is Vamana Dev. He came as Vamana Dev. So in this way, there is Adwaraka appearance and Sadwaraka appearance. Of course, we have to understand who are these father mothers that Krishna appearing from. Krishna's father, Krishna's mother, are they some ordinary lady? Krishna's mother? Is she some special lady?
Is Vasudev just some demigod, as has been described here? No. No lady, no man can become father, mother of Krishna. As I said, Bhagavan's father, mother, they're eternally there in the spiritual world. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Jibbe Daya Kare Sa Parsada Siyodhama Saha Abhatare. When the Lord comes to this material world, He does not come to the material world. Material world is Maya. But Maya can never touch Bhagavan Vishnu or Krishna. Then how Krishna will come to this material world? That is the reason when He comes from spiritual world, Sa Parsada Siyodhama Saha Abhatare. He brings His associates. He brings His abode dhamma to this material world. He manifests from the spiritual world. All His father, mother, brothers, gopa, gopis, cowherd boys, Jamuna, Govardhan, everybody comes from the spiritual world. Any living entity cannot become father, mother of Krishna, because living entities, your marginal potency, your tatastha shakti. Krishna has nothing to do with it, this external or tatastha shakti. His activities take place by internal potency, swarup shakti, chit shakti, swarup shakti. But we are not His swarup shakti. We are marginal potency. So when Krishna comes, He brings His father, mother, who are personification of His swarup shakti. Just like Srimati Radharani. Srimati is Radharani, is personification of what shakti? Haradini shakti. Transformation of Haradini shakti. Same way, Nanda, Yashoda, Devaki, Vasudev, the transformation of Sandhini Shakti. Sandhini Shakti is ever existential potency of Krishna. Sandhini Shakti is known as Dharana Shakti, which carried Krishna. Who can carry Krishna? Only Krishna can carry Krishna. Who are that power can carry Krishna? That's why Bhagavatam states, Devakyam Deva Rupinyang. Prabhupada explaining, Devakyam Deva Rupinyang. Devaki Deva Rupinyang or Vishnu Rupinyang. Devaki is non-different from Vishnu. Devaki can carry. She is non-different from Vishnu. How she is non-different from Vishnu? Because His swarup shakti, internal potency of Krishna. So this is the truth behind Krishna's father, mother. Anybody cannot become Krishna's father, mother. Krishna's father, mother come from the spiritual world. But then we have heard when Krishna appeared in Kamsa prison house, Devaki Vasudev were praying. And Krishna explained, don't be worried. I have come as your son, not only this life. Previously also I came as your son. When you were Prisni and Sutapa, you went through severe austerities to get liberation. But when I appeared in front of you, so you being bewildered, you asked me, I want a son, but I want a son like you. But I have, there is nobody like me. So I had to come myself as your son. So Sutapa Prishni, I came as Prishni Garbha. The next time I came also as your son, as Bamanadev from Aditi and Kasyapa. Then now you have taken birth as Vasudev and Devaki, I am taking birth again.
And also Purana describes about Nanda and Yashoda. There Dhara and Drona. They went for 10,000 years severe austerities to get some blessings from Brahma. Then when Brahma appeared, they wanted a son, they wanted Bhagavan as their son. Brahma said, Tathastu. So, Krishna's, you can become Krishna's father, mother by doing austerity, by doing some punya, by doing some yoga systems. You can become father, mother of Krishna. Jiva Goswami is saying, no, it is not possible. What an injustice is this to say like this, that by doing severe austerities, they get a boon from Brahma and they got Krishna's father, mother. He's saying, it's great anyaya, injustice to speak like this. Nobody can do by doing severe austerities. You can't become Krishna's father, mother. But his explanation is, Dhara and Drona, their expansion of Yashoda and Nanda. Because Parikshit Maharaj asked a question to Sukadev Goswami. In the course of this discussion, Parikshit Maharaj asked a question to Sukadev Goswami, Nanda king akarad brahmana Yashoda va Mahabhaga. Nanda king akarad, what Nanda has done? And he became so fortunate to have Bhagavan Krishna as his son. What mother Yashoda has done? Jasaistanna papai Hari. That Hari, Lord Hari, personally came to drink milk from her breast. So because he asked this question, so in this context, Sukadeva Goswami, to give answer, he described the previous lives. But that does not mean you do tapasya, you become father, mother of Krishna. So Dhara, Drona, it happened, the expansion of Nanda and Yashoda, then they went through this tapasya, this, that, what has happened. So this is what about the father, mother of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So that also proves that appearance or birth of Supreme Personality of Godhead is not ordinary, simple. The transcendental nature that he appears from himself. Devakyam Devarupinyam, he appears from Devaki. Devaki is non-different from him because she is the personification of his internal potency, Hladini Shakti, the Swarup Shakti. So in this way Krishna's appearance is completely different. This transcendental nature of Krishna's appearance. Then I will discuss that when Krishna appears in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna has said, when he appears, what time he appears? Paritranaya sadhunang vinayasa cha duskritang dharma sansthapanartha sambhavami yuge yuge. That every yuga I come. Is it true? Krishna comes every yuga? Yes? Yes or no? He does not come every yuga. Tritiya yuga Rama came. Chaturtha yuga Narasimha came. He came in Dwapara yuga only. But he is saying, I come every yuga means my incarnations I come. Ete chansa kalapunsa krishnasta bhagavan swayam. I am swayam bhagavan. I don't come every yuga, but my incarnations comes. Then when Krishna comes? Krishna comes only in one day of Brahma. That is called kalpa. Just like we have a yuga avatar. Every yuga, yuga avatars comes. They are called yuga avatars. Every yuga they come. Manantar avatar. Every manantar one avatar comes. Called manantar avatar. Krishna is avatari, but also he is called as kalpa avatar. Kalpa means one day of Brahma. is kalpa. And one day Brahma means how long it is. Satya Tritya Dwapar Kali, 1000 time, there is one day of Brahma. There are 14 manus ruling in one day of Brahma, 14 manu. Swayambhuva manu, Sarichisa manu, Uttama manu, Tamasa manu, Raibata manu, Chakshusa manu. Now is Vaivaswata manantara. On the seventh manu, lifetime, and each manu has 71 Dibya Yuga or Chatur Yuga or Yuga cycle. Satya Tritya Dwapar Kali, 71, one manu rules. So Ashtavinshati Chatur Yuga Dwapar Sese. Ashtavinshati 28th Chatur Yuga, end of Dwapara, Krishna appears. So that is when Krishna appears. Krishna appeared. How many years before Krishna appeared? How many years? 5,000 years ago. 5,000 years ago Krishna appeared. But from since I joined ISKCON, I am hearing 5,000 years ago. Since my childhood I am hearing. Is not because 5,001, 5,002, 5,003. Will it continue like this? Whenever we hear class of Krishna appeared 5,000 years ago. But our acharyas, they have found by proper calculation exactly how many thousand years ago he appeared. At one place, I have written a book, Mystery of Krishna's Appearance, because it is in Bengali. There I have mentioned this calculation I found somewhere. I can remember now. Okay. According to astrology, Kali Yuga appeared 3101 before Christ BC. 3000? You have to help me in this calculation. 3101. Okay. So, Shastra says the day Krishna left planet, same day Kali Yuga started. The day he left, and that day was Friday. Sunaya? Krishna left on Friday and he appeared in Wednesday. His appearance was Wednesday and he left on planned on Friday. And the day he left, same day, Kali Yuga entered. So let us calculate. Then Kali Yuga started BC 3101. So 3101 and now 2017. So 3101 and 2017 become 5118. 5118. Okay. Then how long Krishna had his manifested pastimes? How long? 125. He appeared in Vrindavan something like 11 years, 6 months, then Mathura, 12 years, 6 months, 25, then Dwaraka, 100 years, 125. So 5,118 plus 125. How much is that? Any good calculator? It is 5,243. So 5,243. Maybe onwards in ISKCON, at least we should, just like you saying, Gaur Purnima, the 523 appearance of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, we should start telling that in our invitation card. That 500, 2043 appearance day of Lord Krishna. Certainly more continuation will be better. Otherwise people will, for next 500 years, 1000 will become 5,000 years Krishna appeared. They will always talking like that. This calculation should be there. So this is what our appearance on this specific tithi, 5,243 years, this Bhadra month of Bhadra, Krishna Paksha, Ashtami tithi, that Krishna appeared on this earthly planet. So this is what I explained to you, when he appears. Now one interesting point we'll discuss, why he appears. why Bhagavan to come to this material world? What business he has? He is so happily staying in spiritual world. Why he has to come to this material world? Simple reason Krishna has given in Bhagavad Gita. Why he comes to this material world? Why? For three reasons he comes. What are three reasons? Paritranaya sadhanam, vinashaya cha, diskrutam, dharma sansthapanarthaya. To deliver sadhus, to annihilate all the miscreants, to re-establish dharma. But our Gaudiya Acharya, they don't agree with this statement of Krishna. Their argument is that paritranaya sadhana, to deliver sadhus. But sadhus are already delivered. What you have to deliver sadhu? What problem that they have that you have to come here to deliver them? What is problem for them? Vinashaya cha duskritam, to annihilate the miscreants. So the, is it necessary that Bhagavan has to come from spiritual world to annihilate miscreants? Necessary? Simply by his desire, the whole universe is annihilated. Simply by his desire, simply by his drishti, his glance, things are created. Maya dhakshana pakriti svita saracharacham, such a powerful. Tumi sarveshwara sara brajendra kumar, tumar icchai vishwara sejana sanghar. Tumar icchai. By his just desire, simple by his desires, things get annihilated. Then why he has to come personally and to fight with people? What is necessary? So this could not be real reason. Dharma sansthapanarthaya. All great acharyas are there. They can come and re-establish dharma. So according to our Gaudiya Vaishnava acharyas, these three reasons are not real reason why Bhagavan comes. These are secondary reasons. Gauna, secondary reason, or anusanghika karan, gauna karan, why Bhagavan comes. I am not talking about why Krishna comes. I am talking why Bhagavan comes. Bhagavan comes paritranaya sadhanang vinashaya cha duskritang dharma sansthapanarthaya. It is a side effect, byproducts, secondary reason. But what is his real reason? Why he comes? So he, Shastra describes that he comes madbhakta vinodartham karami vividhakriya. I come to this material world, exhibit my sweet activities, pastimes, to give pleasure to my devotees. Madbhakta vinodartham, to make my devotees happy. My devotees are feeling separation from me. In order to give happiness to my devotees, I come to this material world. Killing miscreants is not my main business. I come to give pleasure to my devotees. Madhvakta vinodartham karami vividhakriya. Kunti Devi in her prayer, she is also saying, when Krishna is about to leave Hastinapur, the Kurukshetra battle has ended, Krishna will go, now Krishna is going to say goodbye to everybody. When he went to meet Kunti Devi, what she said? She said, bhakti yoga vidhanartham katham pasyam hastriya. What is that verse? Amalatma muninam amalatmanam, muninam amalatmanam bhakti yoga vidhanartham katham pasyam hastriya. Oh Lord, you have come to give bhakti yoga to the people, to get muni rishi to give bhakti. How can I understand you? So two main reasons. Madhbhakta vinodartham, to give pleasure to my devotee. Bhakti yoga vidhanartham, to give bhakti to my devotee.
This could be considered as the main reasons. And also it has been stated, why Lord comes from a spiritual world? Anugrahaya bhaktanang manusam tanumasrita bhajate tadrisakrida jasruta tataparabhavet. See another reason. Anugrahaya bhaktanang, being merciful unto his devotees, bhajate tadrisakrida. He come as Krishna, as Rama, to exhibit his pastimes as ordinary human beings. So that people will hear jasruta tataparabhavet. People hearing my transcendental activities, they will be attracted to come back to my abode. So he appears here to attract the living entities, to reclaim the living entities, to take them back to Godhead. So Lord comes that he will perform his sweet pastimes. So that people will hear through their ear holes. Pravista karnarandrana swanubhava sararuha dhunati samalam krishna salilasya jathasara. Pravista karnarandrana. Entering through their ear holes will go to their heart. Then samalam krishna, krishna katha, krishna's name, will cleanse just like the water of in the rainy season, water in lake, in oil, in the river are very dirty. But when autumn comes, become very clean. So that is the reason why Krishna, why Bhagavan comes time to time. So these are the main reasons to give pleasure to his devotee. Then to give bhakti to his transcendental pastimes, attract the living entities to go back to Godhead. So I described what are the secondary reason why Bhagavan comes in different forms. What are the primary reasons why Bhagavan comes? So now why Krishna comes? Is Krishna Bhagavan? Yes. Is he only Bhagavan? He is Swayam Bhagavan. Ishwara Parama Krishna, his Parameshwar Swayam Bhagavan. So that means there must be some special reason, no? That all other Bhagavan cannot do. Rama dimurti sukala niyamanatista nana avatar akarat bhuvanesu kintu Krishna swam samabhavet parampumanja govindam adipurusam tamam bhajami. Swam Bhagavan Krishna comes all the way from Golok Vrindavan. Unless there is some special reason, unless there is something that other incarnation cannot do, then why you will come to this material world? So what are the reasons why Krishna comes? Who knows? Why Krishna comes? And if you know, speculate. You can speculate. Prabhupada says, devotee speculates, that also correct. To giving? To give pleasure. That any incarnation comes also to give, to, I just explained, na? Madhvakta vinadartham, that is not for Krishna. Any incarnation comes to give pleasure to his devotees. What? To enact specific pastimes. Each Bhagavat Swarup has a specific pastimes. Narasimha has his specific pastimes. Rama has his specific pastimes. So Krishna has his specific pastimes. Okay, I'll tell you. So try to understand, try to remember that what is specific reasons Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami has revealed in Chaitanya Charitamrita. And he has described, before he describes the external region and internal region for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, came, what is his external reason, what is internal reason. So there he is describing this, just like Krishna's external reason and internal reason. External reason he is saying, paritranaya sadhanam vinashaya duskritam. But he has internal reason. Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has one reason which relates to the living entities. By giving holy name, he will give prem to everybody. That is his external reason. But he has one reason, internal reason, that he wanted to fulfill three unfulfilled desires of Krishna in Krishna incarnation. Same way, Krishna has two reasons. You have to listen carefully. Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami describes, Premarasa nirjasa karite aswadana, one reason, I'll explain in English. Ragamarga bhakti loke karite prasarana. First reason is to release the essence of love. Premarasa, rasa means mellow, prema means love, nirjasa means essence, aswadana means to release, taste. Premarasa nirjasa karitya aswadana, to release the mellows of love, the essence of mellows of love of Brajavasis. Premarasa. So Krishna, you have to prove who is Param Brahma. Whatever we speak, we have to support from Shruti, from Veda. Otherwise, in higher level, they are not accepted. So that's why our acharyas, they are supporting. Who is Param Brahma? Na rasa vahi saha. Rasa means mellows. That Shruti says rasa vahi saha. He is made up of mellows. He releases mellows. And he makes living entity to release mellows. So here we see that premarasa nirjasa, that he came to release the mellows of love. That is one reason. You agree with this? That Krishna came to release the mellows of love? Yes? Yes? You agree? Why? In Goloka Vrindavan he is not releasing any mellows? There is no love in Goloka Vrindavan? Yes or no? If there is love in Goloka, he is releasing already there. So why he has to come to this material world? So what is the difference, the love in Goloka Vrindavan, love here in material world? Why to become essence? Two things, for two reasons. The way I have understood, I am presenting you. The way I have understood, what are the two specials? One is, in Goloka Vrindavan, Radharani, all gopis, because as you know, among all the mellows, rasas, Santa, Dasya, Sakya, Vastala, Madhur. Madhur is the highest. Yes? In Madhur Rasa, the gopis and Radharani, Madhur Rasa, they're rendering service to Krishna, they love Krishna, Krishna enjoy. Krishna's source of enjoyment is love. He is enjoying. But when Krishna pastimes takes place in spiritual world, Braja Gopika Radharani's love becomes more intensified. How? Because in spiritual world, Radharani, Braja Gopika, they all understand, they know Krishna is our husband. We are all eternal consort of Krishna. They know that. Everybody knows that. There is no restriction, no hindrance, no obstacles. But what makes their love to become more intensified? That when this Bhauma Lila takes place, in Brajabhumi, the Yogamaya arranges the apparent marriage of Radharani and Gopis with other cowherd boys. As a result, all Brajabhasi, they think the Gopis and Radharani, they are wife of somebody else. Radharani also thinks, I am wife of somebody else. Radharani does not know Krishna, my eternal husband. Krishna does not know Radharani, my eternal consort. So this is what makes their releasing rasa more special.
The speciality is Radharani Gopi, that they belongs to other husbands. And to meet to Krishna, they have to overcome so many obstacles, so many hindrances. So when you try to reach your lovable object, bypassing, overcoming, surpassing so many obstacles, your love becomes more intense. And that is the essence of love. You understand? That is what Krishna wanted to release. Prema rasa nirjasa, the essence of love is here. It's more intensified. That is one reason. That is called in Brajas parakya rasa. Yogamaya arranges these things. Krishna doesn't understand Brajagopika's his eternal concerts, and Brajagopi, they don't understand also Krishna. So this is the reason why it is called essence of love. And one other is, in loving affairs, in Golok Vrindavan, eternally they are serving Radharani, Brajagopis, Brajavasis, they are eternally serving Krishna. They are very happy. But Prabhupada is saying, in loving affairs, there are two levels. One is called love in sambhog, in union. Another is called love in separation. It is assumed in spiritual world there is no separation. They are eternally serving Krishna. But what happens in this material world? There is an opportunity of separation. Separation called viraha, vipralamba. So Prabhupada is saying that love becomes more intensified in separation than in union. He is giving example of a wife. Wife serving her husband. She is enjoying, she is happy. But when husband goes to far distance, wife always think about her husband. So this is very more intensely become connected to her husband. That's why in loving affairs, matters, the separation is greater than union. So for these two reasons, it has been considered this essence of love, that Krishna came in this Bhauma Lila, that he will release the parakya rasa under this vipralamba or viraha rasa. That makes more intense. That is the first reason why Krishna came. You remember this? It's too much to remember? A few times you will hear, you can make it up, no problem. The main principle, you just try to understand one sentence, that he came, the first reason is, I'll make you to remember. What is the first reason? To release the essence of love. Okay, don't forget that. So whomever you meet today, to everybody you tell these two reasons, to release the essence of love. And why it is the essence of love? The first is parakya rasa, the second is vipralamba. Okay, that is clear. Good. Then second reason is ragamarga bhakti loke karite prasarana. To preach ragamarga bhakti. Ragamarga bhakti, what is ragamarga bhakti? The spontaneous love. The common meaning that Prabhupada has given us, the spontaneous love. As you know, there is Vaidhi Bhakti, there is Raganuga Bhakti. Raganuga Bhakti is following the footsteps of Brajavasis, which is known as Ragatmika. This Bhakti is not found anywhere outside Braj, Ragatmika. Vaidhi Bhakti, One symptom of Vaidhi Bhakti is you do bhakti to the Lord, to God, by the fear of Shastra and Guru, with rules and regulations, following regulatory principles, because of fear of Shastra and Guru, you do bhakti to Bhagavan. It is Vaidhi Bhakti. For example, whatever you are cooking,
your offering to Krishna first. Why are you offering to Krishna? What if you don't offer to Krishna and eat? What will happen? Is there any problem? If you don't offer to Krishna and eat, what is the problem? Mataji? Anybody can say, ah? Then you eat sin. That's why you offer to Krishna, isn't it? We cook nice pizza, pasta, everything, lasagna. So before eating, you remember, oh, I have to offer Krishna, then I'll eat sin. I don't want to eat sin. Krishna, you eat first, then I'll eat. I don't want to eat sin. This is not bhakti. This is karma yoga. I do karma to become free from inabilities of karma. You first eat it. Is this bhakti? Is this prema bhakti? Do we feel, oh, Krishna is so hungry? What Krishna likes? Let me cook quickly. The baby Gopal I have, everybody moving with Gopal. Do you think Gopal is very hungry? What he wants? He needs makhan and misri. But I give a big pizza on plate, you know? Because I like pizza, not he likes pizza. So I just give a crude example, you know, by my understanding. This is one, you know, by the bhakti, by the instructions of scripture due to fear of guru and shastra. And with this bhakti, what happens? As it has been described, you go to Vaikuntha. In Vaikuntha, you see Vishnu. Then you realize, because you are expert in scriptures, so you understand, wow, Vishnu, you are so great. You are Mahan, you are unlimited. You are omnipotent, you are omniscient. Oh Lord Vishnu, you are so great. I am so small. Then you are scared. You are so respectful to His greatness, to His opulence. Then you think, oh my Lord, you are so big, I am too small. What can I do for you? You please do for me. This is Vaidhi Bhakti. You protect me. You maintain me. This is Vaidhi Bhakti. Krishna is thinking, I am bored. I am feeling so bored about these things. People are only coming, you know. Protect me, give me dhanam dahija. Nobody telling you, you please take something. But who can dare? He is omnipotent, he is possessor of everything. Only Brajavasi can think, oh, he is a naughty boy. Only Mother Yashoda can think. The Purushottam, the best Purusha, Mother Yashoda is thinking, this is a naughty boy. If I don't rule him properly, he'll become hippie or loafer like that. No, I don't want to make my boy become hippie like this. I don't want a good human being. These things she wants to do. This Ragamarga Bhakti. Krishna wanted to show. Whole world doing Bhadi Bhakti, but what is Ragamarga Bhakti? I want to show you. In Bhadi Bhakti, everybody glorify Krishna. Nobody chastise Krishna. We pay obeisances, we sit at his lotus feet. But Brajavasis, what they do? The cowherd boys, they climb on Krishna's shoulder. When they play together, when cowherd boys are defeated, Krishna will climb on their shoulder. And Krishna will be defeated? Oh, he's Nanda Baba, he's a king's son. Let me go. No, not like that. Hey, you sit down, we'll climb on your shoulder. Can you do that in Vaikuntha? Can you do that? Can you imagine to? In Vaikuntha, at best, you can do handshake with Vishnu, that's it. Not beyond that. Before I was thinking this handshake system is coming from Western world. But I read Bhagavata somewhere written, in Vaikuntha, Krishna is doing handshake with his devotees. So that was only allowed. You can't lift your hand beyond that. You can't put your hand around the shoulder of Krishna. Around the shoulder of Vishnu in Vaikuntha. What to speak of climbing on his shoulders? But Krishna is saying, always I am doing this handshake. I am feeling boring with this handshake. It's too formal. I enjoy more when cowherd boys, they climb on my shoulders. I enjoy more with that. Krishna is saying, all these great Muni rishis, yogis, they are glorifying me with so much stabha, stuti prayers. When I hear the stabha, stuti prayers, I don't feel that much pleasure. As much as pleasure I feel when the Brajagopikas, they shout, scream, rebuke, scold me. Their scolding gives me very pleasing. Ah, so nice, so nice. Brajagopi is scolding me, I enjoy more. You understand? This is Raga Marga Bhakti. So, Krishna, the second reason is, I'll tell you second reason, if you tell me the first reason. What is the first reason? To enjoy, to release essence of love. The second reason is Raga Marga Bhakti Loka Karita Pracharana. That's what I explained to you all of these things. This kind of bhakti, you have to exhibit it to people, that you are all glorifying me, thinking it's too big. But I have another aspects also. Because until that only Vishnu worshipping, all things going on. Nobody knows. There's another aspects of Lord Krishna or Bhagavan or Parambrahma, where he becomes very informal with his devotees. Krishna saying, when my devotees, they consider me greater than them, I don't enjoy so much. When they consider me, I'm equal to them, or I'm inferior to them, then I enjoy more of that. Who can think Krishna is inferior to me? Can any of us think like that? Can you do? Krishna is equal to me, can you do that? No, it's not so easy. I say, Krishna, I want to show these things, that I enjoy more, I feel more pleasure when I see my devotees are thinking they are greater than me or they are equal to me. This is Raga Marga Bhakti Loke Karita Pracharam. To preach people, to show people this spontaneous love. This is second reason. Clear? Two reasons. What is the second reason? Huh? What is the second reason? Spontaneous love, Raga Bhakti. To exhibit the Raga Marga Bhakti. So Krishna had this desire. In Goloka Vrindavan, he's thinking all this time people are offering this Vaidhi Bhakti. So I'll go. So he developed a desire, that I want to enjoy the essence of love. He developed desire. Who develops desire? When you develop a desire, have you analyzed? When somebody develops a desire? When? Yes, tell me loudly. To enjoy, when you develop a desire? For what you develop a desire? Something you don't have, you develop a desire, no? Isn't it? Something you don't have, you develop a desire. But Bhagavan, he has everything. He is purna kama, atta kama. Why he has to have desire? Then somebody will challenge you. There is a Bhagavan has these two desire, but Bhagavan not supposed to have desire. Because he has everything. Why should you have desires? He's apta kama. But he is having desire, not that he does not have. He has it constitutionally and he wants to enjoy. So what quality he has constitutionally, that his desire for releasing the essence of love can be justified? What is constitution? His constitution is, he's a Rasika Sekhara. He is the topmost releaser of love. Rasika Sekhara, according to Veda. Rasavaisaha. He is the topmost releaser of love. Constitutionally, he's built up like that. Rasam hi eva ayam labdha anandibhavati. when living entities, they reach or they achieve, they get this Krishna, then Anandi Bhavati, they become very blissful. So why he is desiring to release the essence of love? Because he is Rasika Sekhara. He is the topmost releaser of rasa. That is the reason. And why he wants to people to understand Raga Marga Bhakti? Because he is Parama Karuna. He is very merciful. Rasika Sekhara Krishna Parama Karuna Ei Dui Hetu Ichhara Udgama. Ichha means he developed this desire for because of two reasons. Constitutionally, he is Rasika Sekhara, he developed a desire to release the essence of love. Constitutionally, he is Parama Karuna. That is the reason he developed a desire to make people know, understand this Raga Marga Bhakti. So these are the reasons why Krishna comes to this material world. He comes, he descends in one day of Brahma to this material world. So by this I have explained to you what is Krishna's appearance, when he appears, why he appears. In course of my discussion I told you how he appears also. This verse describes Bhagavan api Vishwatma Bhaktanam Abhayankara, that Ananka Dudhuvi Vasudev Anadana, which Ananka Dunduvi, when he appeared, all the demigods there playing Dunduvi in the sky, understanding that Supreme Personality of Godhead will appear from this Vasudeva. So then how Prabhupada saying that Krishna did not appear as ordinary people, they give birth to the children. First, Lord appeared within his heart, with his mind in his heart. Then from his heart, Vasudeva's heart, he was transformed to Devaki heart. This is the way how he appeared. So these are the points I discussed to you. Then as we discussed, there is a reason in this material world why Krishna appears. Before Krishna appears, he makes a region in spiritual world also. Not only when Krishna appears, when Lord appeared in Narasimha, he also made a region, a pastime in Vaikuntha. Jaya Vijaya came, then their course, the whole pastime took place. When Ramchandra came, also Shastra described there is a pastime took place. Then Narada Muni was bewildered by Shiva Maya, then he went to marry somebody, then the whole description, then why? Then Rama said, yes, this is my time, I will descend to the earthly planet. In the same way, Krishna's appearance has origin and pastimes in spiritual world. Most of you know, this has been discussed in my Radharani book, I have mentioned this pastime also. With a few sentences, I will just cover it for your, so that you remember what I am talking about. You have heard once how once in Rasmandal, Radharani was serving Krishna, in ecstasy she fainted, that Krishna left her and went to Viraja's Kunja group to take service from Viraja. Then when Radharani come to consciousness, Krishna is not there, so where is Krishna? The other said he has gone to Viraja. Radharani become very furious, angry. What Viraja knows to serve Krishna? Why he went to Viraja? She doesn't know how to serve Krishna. She was very angry, she picked up a stick in her hand. And she told all her sakhis, you come on my chariot, we will go and see how Viraja serving Krishna. And all her sakhis, they boarded into a chariot. You know how many sakhis helping Radharani to serve Krishna in Golok Vrindavan? Millions. 630 millions only. Brahma Vibhartha Prana explains, only 630 million gopis. And sakhis, they help Radharani to serve one Krishna.
And more interestingly, she had a chariot, and the chariot is so big. All these 630 million sakis, they boarded into that chariot. So imagine how big it would be inside that chariot. The big palaces are there, mountain, gardens, lake, everything is there in that palace. And that moves mind, speed of mind. Anyway, the very nice description is given, how it looks like, how size, many bells are there, what kind of cover is, what kind of cloth is covered, very beautiful description. And when then Radharani went, Krishna has entered into Viraja's Kunja, but Krishna has told Sridham, you guard at the gate. Anybody comes, including Radharani, don't allow inside. So Sridham standing at the gate, very palwan, very powerful, no? Muscular body. Then Radharani came. Oh Sridham, where is your friend Krishna? Sridham said, oh, I don't know where he is. No, I know somewhere. And Radharani, oh, you don't know. You are here means Krishna must be here. So I will go inside this kunja and see what is happening. Sridham said, no, you can't go inside. Sridham is very powerful personality. He may be very powerful personality, but Radharani has only 603 million sakhis. She said, please take care of Sridham. She said, pick him up and put him aside, keep quiet. Radharani wanted to go inside. So when at the doorstep all this conversation going on, Viraja could hear, wow, Radharani has come. She became so scared, she melted into river, she became water. Now, first Krishna disappeared, When he had Radharani has come, he disappeared. So when Krishna disappeared, Viraja became very scared and she melted into the river. Then Radharani went inside. There's no Krishna, no Viraja. And some Maharaja is telling, I have not read in any book, that Radharani is a very good astrologer. And through astrology, she understood what has happened. Oh, Viraja has become one river, and Krishna is hiding in the form of a snake inside the river. She understood. Then she said, okay. Then she took a form of a peacock. Then Maharaja was telling, she took a form of a peacock. Whenever Krishna comes out, I will catch him. The peacock catches the snakes. She took a form of a peacock. So whenever we give class in Bengal, in village, so we give her class, whether the villagers they listen or not, at the end they will come a very odd question that you can never answer it, you know. Old people, they will come up a question. Then one villager, one old man came, Acha Maharaj, can you answer, I have one question. So what is your question? Tell me, why Krishna is putting peacock feather on his head? What answer? I don't know the answer. I said, peacock feather looks very beautiful. Do you think he'll put a crow feather on his head? So in this way I just give some answers. Then later on I came to know that somebody said that Krishna likes peacock because spiritual Lord Radharani once took a peacock form. Since then, Krishna likes this peacock feather very much. That is what has been discussed in Bengal. Then when later on Krishna came, Brahmavihuta Puran describes Krishna came to Radharani. Radharani very angry, don't allow Krishna. All this allow me. Then they're asking Radharani, no, very angry. And some sakhi told Krishna, you please go for some time, sit in next room. When Radharani cool down, then we'll call you. And all these things Sridham watching. And he got more angry, more furious. What nonsense is happening here? And at one point, he became very angry. He told Radharani that you are giving so hard time to my friend or to Krishna. You know for whom we are so great? For Krishna you are so great. And you cannot tolerate few moments separation from Krishna, I curse you. that you will go through 100 years separation from Krishna. You go to earthly planet, take birth there as a gopi, and go through 100 years separation. Radhani also become very angry. And Radhani cursed to Sridham that you are behaving like a demon. You are always supporting your father, not supporting me. You are behaving like a demon. So I curse you. You go to earthly planet and become a demon there. What was that demon, Maharaj? Sankhachuda. You become a demon Sankhachuda there. So they cursed each other. Why somebody curse? Why you curse somebody? When you curse somebody? When you become angry, and you curse. Where anger comes from? From? Kama esa, krudha esa, rajaguna samudbhava. From rajaguna. So is there rajaguna in Goloka Vrindavan? Why is they are becoming angry? Cursing each other. But this cursing, this anger does not arise from rajaguna, tamaguna, satyaguna. This comes because Krishna's plan. Since they cursed each other, they went, after cursing each other, they remained repenting. Siddham and Radha, oh, why we did like this? And Krishna sitting next room. He knows what is going to happen next. They will come to me anyway. He's sitting there peacefully. Then Radhani Siddham went, oh Krishna, we have done a big mistake. We have cursed like this. Krishna, no, there's no mistake. By my desire, all these things has happened because now I have time. I have to go to earthly planet to do my pastimes. Don't be worried. So this is the pastime took place to which Krishna took as a cause to come to this earthly planet. Then Garga Sangita describes the preparation. Krishna preparing to come to this material world. That when earthly planet was too much burden, overburdened by demoniac people, then earthly planet went to pray Vishnu, to pray Brahma. Then Brahma went to pray Shiva, then Vishnu, then all of them, they thought what to do. The situation is as such that Krishna has to come. So Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar, they plan to go to Goloka Vrindavan. So how they will go? So there is a hole, you see, our Brahmanda is there. There are eight layers are there. And beyond that, Biraja River is there. So these eight layers, when Vamanadev, he raised his second feet, through his toe there is a hole, these eight layers. So Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar, so these eight layers they went other side. And there is Biraja River. And there are many, many universes that are floating in Biraja Rivers. And they crossed Biraja Rivers other side. And they saw a huge light. They could not see any huge light. Where to go? Then they found a huge snake in coiled form. A huge snake they saw. Ananta says, coiled form. But that is Sankarsan. Goloka Vrindavan, everything is manifestation of Sankarsan. Then within that they saw the sweet Vrindavan, River Yamuna, Govardhan Vrindavan. Then when they went, then they saw huge lotus flower. 1008 lotus flower petals. Then there is another lotus with eight petals. There Radha Krishna is sitting. Then they went, they informed, this is a big problem in the earthly planet. You have to do some solution, bring some solution. Krishna said, oh, I know. Before you tell me, I know. No problem. Very soon, I am going to come down to the earthly planet. But as soon as Krishna did this sankalpa, the Brahma, they are all sitting there, they saw from different Vaikunthas, Ramchandra came, then merged into Krishna's body.
Narasimha came, merged into Krishna's body. Sahasra Srisa Vishnu came, merged into Krishna's body. This all the forms of Supreme Personality, they all merged into Krishna's body. Now Krishna planning to come to this material world. Krishna told, okay, some of you come with me also. So who will come? Everyone in big line, whose term will be to come to the material world? Why? They are so interested to come to this material world. Spiritual world, there is less pleasure or what? Why everybody wants to come to material world? For a specific purpose. Because in spiritual world, all celebrations are there. Jhulan Jatra is there. Your Rasa Purnima, Rasa Lila is there. But one festival is not there. That is Janmashtami. They have no Janmashtami there. Krishna never took birth. So they have no Janmashtami festival. So they all want to come, we'll go. So everyone wants to go. Okay. Then they planned who will come. The Radhani came to know that Krishna is going to earthly planet. The Radhani came running. What are you doing? If you live, how can I stay here? I can't stay without you. Krishna said, no problem, you also come with me. Krishna said, no, I am not going to go there. No. But I am going, you don't want to go? No, even if you go, I don't want to go there. Why? Because there is no Jamuna, no Giri Govardhan, no Vrindavan. Wherever Jamuna, Giri Govardhan, Vrindavan are there, even if you go, I don't go. And same thing she has exhibited now. She saw Krishna in Kurukshetra. Krishna was there, she did not like. She wanted Krishna, you are same Krishna, but you are not same Krishna. I want you in Vrindavan. So Radharani said, I will not go. Then Krishna said, no problem. I will bring Vrindavan from here. I will bring Jamuna from here. I will bring Giri Govardhan also. You know how Giri Govardhan came from spiritual world to the earthly planet. I will bring everything. Please come. So then Radharani agreed. Then of course then Radharani said, I don't want to see anyone's face. I will see your past and see your face. So this is how the preparation in spiritual world is going on. So there are many different topics, but because now time is late, but before I finish, I'll describe one last pastimes, very crucial pastimes. The crucial pastime of Krishna is Krishna's appearance, which is still very mysterious to people in general. The mysterious in the sense, the whole India, all Hindus, they know Krishna is son of Vasudeva and Devaki. And Jasoda, foster son, few days maintaining. But here is where our philosophy, Mahapurush philosophy, differs from all others' philosophy. All common people in common Hindus, all spiritualists, all Vaishnavs, they have one understanding about appearance of Krishna. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Gaudiya Vaishnavs have a completely different understanding about appearance of Krishna. Our whole Gaudiya philosophy is based on this, on the difference of appearance of Krishna. That Krishna, he actually appeared from the womb of Mother Yashoda. Not as it is believed or understood, has been described, from the womb of Devaki. Yes, he appeared from the womb of Devaki, that is understood. That is how Sukadeva Goswami described. But Sukadeva Goswami did not describe the other part. That actually, the real Krishna took birth as son of Nanda Maharaj Devaki. Because Sukadeva Goswami is thinking that Parikrita Maharaj is going to leave body. If I explain to him that Krishna took birth
in your relatives, because Devaki Vasudev is Sukadeva's relative, no? Hey, Parikitma relative. So Sukadeva Goswami thinking, if I explain Parikit Maharaj that Krishna appeared in your family members, you'll be more happy. So he just described Krishna is Devaki Vasudev's son. Now other person, he did not want to mention that person. But actually Krishna took birth as son of Nanda and Yashoda. And that has been described very nicely by Jiva Goswami. The appearance of Krishna as son of Nanda and Yashoda. So in that dynasty there is a king called Devamidha. Devamidha king, he had two wives. One wife from Kshatriya family, one wife from Vaishya family. You understand? So from Kshatriya family, Devamidha king gave birth to Surasena. And his sons were Devaka and Ugrasena, two brothers. Devaka's daughter was Devaki and Ugrasena's son was Kansa. Understand? That is Kshatriya family. They did Kshatriya job. Wherever family wife is coming from, the system that you will be that belongs to that category. So Kshatriya family wife, Devamidha, so they become Kshatriya. Devamidha, then that's Parjana Maharaj. Then Parjana Maharaj, Surasena and Parjana Maharaj. So Parjana Maharaj took the service of Vaishya, Krishi Goraksha, cow under cow maintenance and agriculture, Parjana Maharaj. And then Parjana Maharaj, he had five sons, Upananda, Abhinanda, Nanda, Sunanda and Nandan. He had five sons. And Parjana Maharaj became old, so he left everything and he went to forest to do Hari Bhajan. Now he take care of the kingdoms. So out of five brothers, the eldest son will become king. Upananda is eldest son. So whole arrangement was done, started. He will be enthroned and he will put into Raj Singhasan. All arrangements done. Then Upananda called Nanda Maharaj. He is middle son. He is not supposed to be king. Eldest son supposed to be king. Then Upananda called Nanda Maharaj, come. Upananda made to sit on his lap. So instead of Upananda put Rajatilak on his forehead, he took Rajatilak and put on Nanda Maharaj's head. Everybody is surprised, but you are the eldest son. Nanda Maharaj said, I am the middle son, I am not supposed to be king. And Upananda said, no, your name is Nanda. I am Upananda. Upananda means side. Nanda is the main one. No? So you become the king. I don't become the king. This is how Nanda Maharaj became king, even if his middle son. But unfortunately, his son had to inherit, but he had no son. And he's already very old. So many yajna they are doing, putrashti yajna, this, that, no son. So one day Nanda Maharaj said to Mother Yashoda, how these people expecting I will have a son by doing the yajna, by putrashti yajna. Yajna is karmakanda. Whenever I sit in yajna, then I meditate to have a son. One son appears in my mind, which is much more beautiful than Narayan. How that son can come by the process of this karmakanda yajna is not possible. Then they would discuss, Yashoda and Nanda, anyway we are too old now, just forget about getting any child. How old Nanda Maharaj was by that time? 90 years old. Somewhere I have read, 90 years old. They dropped. Okay. But still, they said, but I can't give up the desire. I want to have a child. Then they decided to do Dadashi Vrata for 1 year.
both of them, they did Dvadasi Vrata. On the Dvadasi Vrata, end of the Dvadasi Vrata, one day Nanda Maharaj, he felt something. Then he called Mother Yashoda, that I am feeling something. Do you feel something same way? I am feeling one very beautiful blue boy who entered into my heart. And from my heart, then I saw next that boy is playing on your lap. Do you feel such a boy playing on your lap? Then Mother Yashoda, she felt very shy. She said, yes, I also feel same way. But I don't tell to anybody. It is very embarrassing. We are so old. There is no chance we'll have any baby now. So I'm not telling anybody, but I am feeling the same way. Then they realized. Then after some time, then Mother Yashoda, she manifested all the symptoms of a pregnant lady. She did not get any taste of eating. And only she would eat, she would get a very good taste when they would offer some sweet rice cooked with milk and tulasi leaves. I should enjoy, should like that, because Krishna is there inside her womb. Then, in the meantime, Balaram, because Rohini was there in Nanda Maharaj's house, Balaram had taken birth, but when Balaram took birth, he remained like a dump, like blind, cannot speak anything, not blind, cannot speak anything, cannot hear anything, like a dump. But whenever baby Balaram, Mother Yashoda would take baby Balaram on his lap, then immediately Balaram would laugh and very jubilant because Krishna is there with the womb of Mother Yashoda. So in this way, when time came, at proper time, Mother Yashoda gave birth not only to Krishna, he gave birth to Krishna and Yogamaya, one boy and one girl. What whole world knows that he gave birth to, Majasada gave birth to one girl only, but actually he gave birth to one boy and one girl. As all of you know, that how that Vasudevan got married, Kansa was riding with Kansa, his brother of Devaki, that not from same father. Ugrasena's son is Kansa, Devaka's son is Devaki, but they are brother and sisters. Very happily, jubilantly, Kansa was riding the chariot, carrying Devaki and Vasudev. But the unseen sound vibration said, oh fool, you Kansa fool, you are carrying this lady, and whose eighth son will be cause of your death. And immediately all affection finished. He caught hold of the hair of Devaki and prepared to kill her. Vasudev in great danger. Then he tried him so many times, so many giving philosophical arguments, but nothing worked. Finally Vasudev said, okay, I promise, we make a deal. Your fear is not from Devaki, but from our eighth son. But what to speak of eighth son? As soon as any son will take birth, I will give that child to you. You kill that child. And Kansa agreed. It's a good settlement. That you kill all my child, I don't care, don't kill my wife. It's a good settlement. Vasudev is thinking, Vasudev is thinking, I may not have any child. Let me protect my wife first. Maybe before my eighth son come, Kansa may die. And finally I was thinking, if unseen sound has said my eighth son will kill, anyway he will kill. So that's why he put this condition. Then Kansa agreed. And but when Devaki gave birth to child, first son, Devaki, what is his name? Devaki's first son? You don't see TV serial? I not understand. Kirtiman, Bharata, Kirtiman. So Vasudev is so truthful, he brought this Kirtiman. And Devaki, to Kansa, please kill. The Kansa saw, you become very affectionate, my nephew. No? And says, very affectionate. No, I don't want to kill my nephew. Okay, Vasudev, this unseen sound vibration has said, eighth son, please take back this. I don't want to kill. Vasudev was very happy. Was he happy?
he was not happy. But he knows he is a notorious person. Anytime he may kill also, he is not happy. That conscious spirit, my son. And he came. But then the demigods became very worried. What is this? Conscious became very merciful. It's very dangerous for us. He should become more notorious, more cruel, so that Krishna will come quick. If Krishna conscious develops good nature, it's very dangerous for us. Then they send Narad Muni to induce Kansa. What mistake are you doing? Kill this, now all these sons. Then Narad Muni said, came and told Kansa, do you know, I was coming in the space, I went to Kumeru or Sumeru, some mountain. And all demigods having meeting. And they are there discussing there. They are all taking birth in Jadubansa. But you should kill everybody. No. So that he will do more sinful activities, that Krishna will come. Kansa said, yes, yes, very much correct. Then he started to kill one after another. All six sons were killed. Actually, these six sons, he is thinking, I am killing Devaki sons. But they are all Kansa's sons. They are called Sat-Garbhasura. They are all Kansa's sons. Kansa is commonly known as son of Ugrasen, but actually he is not son of Ugrasen. He is known as Durmila Nandana. And Kansa's mother, Ugrasen's wife, one day she was playing ball on the roof of the building. And one demon, Durmila, was flying. And she picked up Ugrasen's wife and associated with her. That is how Kansa took birth as a demon. And he was killing all the sons there. Kansa previous life was Kalanami, demon. And that life, all the six children of Devaki, they were son of Kalanami. But they were caused to be killed by Kalanami. The six sons of Kalanami, once they went to observe severe austerities to become immortal, then Hiranyakashipu said, oh, was that my permission you are trying to become immortal? I curse you will be killed by in the hand of your father. That is the reason Kalanami took birth as Kansa and his six children took birth as Sat-Garbhasura. Then when six demons were killed, how Krishna can come in that womb? Then Krishna first sent Balaram, Shankarsan, you make arrangements for me. So that is the reason even if Balaram's eternal mother is Rohini, first he appeared in Devaki's womb. Then he was by Yogamaya transferred from Devaki's womb to Rohini's womb. Then as eighth child, then Krishna appeared, Vasudev Krishna appeared. Then Krishna told Vasudev, you take me to the other side of Yamuna, leave me in Nanda Maharaj's house. There's one girl, you bring the girl back. Then Vasudev, following order, put in a basket and carrying, and reached at the gate, dark night. He can't see anything. Then one jackal came, that is Durga Parvati, Mahamaya, came in the form of jackal, to show him the path. Going outside, so much rain, how can he go? Then Anantasasa came, bring his head, saving him for the rain. Then Vasudeva was moving very nicely. Midnight, dark night. At one point, he's going, somebody called, who is that? Who is that? Who is running away? That is Ugrasen. Ugrasen was appointed as gatekeeper by Kansa. Kansa through Ugrasen, his father, and he became king. And he made Ugrasen his security man. So Ugrasen was giving guard. Then Ugrasen found somebody is going away. Then Vasudeva could hear, wow, now I am caught. How Vasudeva, every movement he has problem. Every movement. That is what love is. Then Ugrasen came, who is that? Then saw Vasudeva. Why are you running away? Then Vasudeva saw this baby son. Then there Krishna saw his forearmed form. Then Ugrasen offered obeisances. Okay, go away, quickly go, hidingly.
Then Vasudev carrying Krishna came to Yamuna.
So much water there, full of water. How will cross? There's no boat.
Then Vasudev became very worried. Then Vasudev saw a jackal is walking in the water, and water level has come down. Then Vasudev thought, if jackal is going, then why can't I go? So Vasudev said to follow the jackal. And they reached in the middle of the Yamuna, and all of a sudden Krishna fell into the water. And Vasudev searching, where is my Krishna? Just imagine what would be his feeling now after so much struggle bringing Krishna. Then Yamuna came, the lady form. Now, then said, now I wanted to get now Krishna also in my lap. Then gave Krishna. Then Nanda Vasudev brought Krishna to Nanda Maharaj's house. By yoga maya's influence, everybody is sleeping. Mother Yashoda too tired, she was sleeping. Then Vasudev kept Krishna there and took the baby girl to prison house. And then when she was brought crying, then Kamsa came and tried to kill this baby girl by throwing the girl into the stone, onto the stone. But baby girl, the Yogamaya who took birth in Nanda Maharaj's house, she transformed to Mahamaya. The Kamsa cannot see Yogamaya. And she flew from Kamsa's hand and said, you fool trying to kill me? One who will kill you has taken birth in some other place. So Kamsa was very frightened. So this is how Krishna appeared, in Chaturbhuja Vasudev form. Then he was transformed. So what our acharyas are saying, there is one boy and one girl. Krishna was there and Yogamaya girl was there. When Vasudev brought Krishna, his son Vasudev Krishna, and took Yogamaya, the two Krishna merged together. Then they become one Krishna, Yogamaya. Then Yogamaya left from prison house. But now people, they ask, why all this drama is going on, natak? One Krishna here, one Krishna there, going merging. Why all these things happening? Why? Krishna never leaves Vrindavan, that is okay, good. Krishna took birth in Vrindavan, is fine. But why this another Krishna has to come and merge? Vasudev Krishna, that is because this Vrindavan Krishna, he has no business in killing any demons. That is not his business. His business play on flute, play with Gopa Gopis. Then how all these demons will be killed? For that purpose Vasudev Krishna came. So through Vasudev Krishna, all demons were killed. When Krishna, as Prabhu is saying, Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. But when Krishna left Vrindavan, as Krishna did not leave Vrindavan, Krishna stayed behind, within the heart of the gopis. As you have heard from Bhagavatam, when Akura was taking Krishna Balaram, he wanted to take bath, and he saw Krishna Balaram in Vishnu form. So it is believed that time Vasudev Krishna left, but real Krishna stayed in the heart of the gopis. When gopis met Krishna, said, why you left Vrindavan? Krishna said, I have not left, I am still in Vrindavan. You just saw me, I have left Vrindavan. That is all gopis thinking, Akura took. But actually Krishna said, I am in Vrindavan, I am having pastimes with you also. Because gopis, they saw Krishna, Akura took Krishna, so they are thinking this is all dream. They think it is all dream. But actually it is not dream. Actually Krishna stayed in Vrindavan. This way, how Krishna appeared and he had his sweet pastimes. Jai Sri Krishna Bhagavan ki, Sri Krishna appearance day celebration ki, Gaur Premanande Hari Hari. Thank you so much. Maharaj, you want to say something? Maharaj, some comments? Look, end of today's fasting, so you don't have to worry. And those, they are worried people, they have not come anyway. When people have some patience, they are here. So you have to add something, little bit, Maharaj can add. Give Maharaj this phone, microphone. The same though you have recited. No. Bhagavan api viswatma bhaktana vayatma. I will find out there. I will read that verse I found out there. This is when Maharaj was speaking about Divya, not the usual birth. As Krishna talks in Bhagavad Gita, janma karma chamet divyam. How Krishna appearance, janma divya, transcendental. That's the beginning part. Sukadeva Goswami described that. Bhagavan api viswatma, Krishna is viswatma, Bhagavan possesses all the six opulences. Bhaktanam abhayankara avivesa, Krishna entered nicely, very nice way entered ansabhagena along with all other incarnations were included in Krishna, all inclusive. Avishar Anand Dundhave, Manah in the mind of Anand Dundhave, Vasudev. So Krishna, before coming in the womb of Mother Devaki, Krishna appeared or entered in the mind of Vasudev, or the heart of Vasudev. And once Vasudev got Krishna, sa bibhrat paurusam dhama vrajmano yatharavi. As soon as Krishna entered in the mind of or heart of Vasudev, Vasudev became as brilliant as sun itself. It was very difficult to duradharsa. It was very difficult to look upon him, such brilliance he got. And then next verse talks, Tato jagan mangalma chudangsam samahitam surasutena devi dadhara sarvatmakmatma bhutam kashta yathananda karam manushta. And then Sukadeva Goswami described that from the mind of Vasudev or from the heart of Vasudev, Krishna entered in the heart of Mother Devaki. This was the process, how Krishna... So Krishna was transferred from the mind of Vasudev in the heart of our mind of Mother Devaki, and there, so thus Devaki got Krishna. This is the process, avatar. And as soon as here description that Devaki, when she got Krishna in her heart, sa Devaki sarv jagan nivasa nivasa bhutam nitaram nareje. So Devaki become the residence of Krishna, who is the sarva jagan nivasa, all universe, everything existing, material, spiritual world, that is within the Krishna. And Krishna was in the womb of Mother Devaki. So she become jagan nivasa nivasa bhuta. Mother Devaki become the residence of Krishna, who holds within him all universes. But here it appears that Sukadev Goswami regrets that her beauty, her opulence was not appreciated by people in general, because she was confined in the prison house of Kamsa. So people in general, they have not opportunity to see the such a glorious beautiful form of Mother Devaki, because she was confined in the prison house of Kamsa. Bhojendra gehe agni sikhe varudha saraswati gyan khale yatha sati. The glories or opulence or beauty of Devaki was not known, because she was confined in the prison house of Kamsa. And Sukadeva Goswami gives an example. Gyan khale sarasati yatha. Gyan khal, that person is considered very condemned, the person is considered to be very condemned, one who has learning, some gyan is there. But he doesn't share, he doesn't preach, doesn't teach that knowledge to other people, and that person is called gyan khal. So that learning, any wisdom, doesn't get appreciated, or people doesn't get opportunity to know that philosophy, that knowledge. So similarly, Devaki's situation was, since she was in the prison house of Kamsa, her beauty, her opulence, or her glory was not appreciated by people in general. People don't get opportunity to see Devaki. So one day, in this, just I am speaking a few words, I will conclude with this word. So one day, because it was known, one day, every time to time, since Devaki was in prison, so time to time comes, used to visit the prison house. So one day he came to see Devaki. Tamviksha Kamsa Parvayajitantara. That day Kamsa saw Viksha Parvayajitantara. He saw such brilliance, her beauty, her brilliance has increased many times. Virochayanti bhavanam suchasmita. Otherwise, every time Kamsa used to visit Devaki, she was very morose, distressed condition, everything. But today he saw suchasmita. She was smiling, very nicely smiling. And virochayanti bhavanam. And she was diminishing the darkness of the house. From her body, such a brilliance was coming out, and that brilliance was diminishing. The whole prison house was illuminated by the
opulence or her brilliance. Virochayantim bhavanam suchismita. She was very much happy, smiling. Suchismita, pavitra, pure smiling was there in her face, and her body was such brilliant that whole prison house was completely illuminated without an and then ahesh me pran haro harim guha. All of a sudden Kamsa uttered ah is this in her womb, in the womb of Devaki. Certainly Hari has entered. Harim dhruvam srutojan parime. Because otherwise I have seen Devaki from very beginning of my life, when she was a child. She was never ever such a, she was never such a beautiful and same time never happy. What could be the reason of her happiness and her brilliance? So he concluded, certainly Krishna, Hari, had entered her womb. Then what should I do? Kimadya tasmin karaniya masu. Now, that directly, the Akashvani has told, predicted that eighth son of Devaki would be cause of your death, my death. So now Krishna, the eighth child of Devaki, has entered in her womb. Then what should I do? In first he thought, let me kill Devaki immediately. But he said, no, I will not. Nayadra tantro navidhan. If I will do this, certainly I will ruin my reputation, my yash. So wide reputation I will lose. Not only I will lose yash, sriyam, my opulence and duration of my life. If I will do this thing, if I will kill, I would kill Devaki, certainly immediately I will lose my reputation, I will lose my opulence, and I will lose my duration of life. Why? Striya. Because this is a woman hurting, inflicting pain or any type of distress upon the woman considered to be the most sinful activity. So I can't do this. Swasubha. She is my sister, Guru Matya. Not only she is my younger sister, and same time she is pregnant. So she doesn't deserve to be killed by me. If I dare killing her, immediately I will be bereft of my yash, my opulence, and my duration of my life. So this is change. Kamsa was, always he was changing, flickering mind. Many times he changed his decision. The day, we know that very much celebrated pastime, when Vasudev married Devaki, and there was ceremonial procession in the street of Mathura. Different type of, the procession was going on street of Mathura right after marriage of Devaki and Vasudev. And nice ceremonial procession was there. Different type of instrument, specious instrument they are playing. Brahmana was reciting a specious mantra. And whole the, it was jubilant procession. From the top, demigods are raining the flower, throwing the flowers. Such a nice atmosphere. At that time, demigod, they directly address to Kamsa. Say, Kamsa, you are fool number one. You don't know what you are doing. You are giving so much respect, honor for a lady, a girl, Devaki, you don't know what will happen. Her eighth child will kill you. The eighth child of Devaki would be reason of your death. You are showing so much respect and affection for this lady. So Akashvani, the demigod, directly addressed to comes and then his mind absolutely changed. And he was ready to kill there publicly. All the royal family was there. Brahmana was reciting mantra. Whole citizen, important citizen, were there participating in their profession, procession. Right there he wanted to kill Devaki. But here today he saying, if I would kill Devaki, I will be bereft from yash, reputation, opulence, and I will reduce my duration of my life. That day in the street of Mathura, she was also his sister. She was also woman. She wanted to kill immediately Devaki, but today he said, no, no, this I can do. What could be reason? Because now Devaki, Krishna was within the womb of Mother Devaki. So whosoever developed Krishna prema or hold Krishna within his heart, immediately when the cruel person also get changed simply by seeing. So today, since Devaki was pregnant, she was holding Krishna in her womb. That reason why such a cruel person, cruel like Kamsa, as soon as he saw Devaki, immediately his mind changed, he became melted and he did, no, no, this sinful activity I should not do. Sriya, I should not kill her because she is woman, Istri. Sasubh, my own younger sister and Guru Matya, pregnant. So I should not. So it comes this. So this one scene in prison house of Kamsa. But again he changed his mind. He went inform his minister that this has happened today. I have visited in the prison house and Devaki is such a brilliant. Certainly I can tell with all my confidence that certainly Krishna has entered in her womb and he would kill me. Then what I should do? Then those ministers, they are not so much experienced and they are cruel person. Then many things they plan, we will go through that. So here one Maharaj in beginning was Bhagavan api Vishwatma Bhakta Nam Abhayankara Avivesa Ansa Bhagena Manah Anak Dundumbe. This is Janma Karmam Chame Dibyam. It's not in ordinary process in material world a child takes place, not a similar thing. Usually a living entity takes shelter of the semen of the father and enters in the womb of mother. Why? This is the regular way. But this is not in case of Krishna. Krishna directly entered in the mind of Vasudev, and from the mind of Vasudev, Krishna was transferred in the heart of Mother Devaki. And of course, in order to give pleasure, Krishna resided there for many months, approximately 7 months in the womb of Mother Devaki. So this is transcendental situation, and as we know, Krishna came out from the womb of Mother Devaki and he had four-handed form, Chaturbhuj. And from top to bottom, he was decorated with different type of ornament. Not only ornament in his arms, he has conch shell. You know the Sudarshan, Panch Janya Mhrishikesh, and Chakra, Sudarshan Chakra, कौमुद की गदा एंड वन लीला कमल लोटस फ्लावर. वी हैव नो एनी एक्सपीरियंस इन दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड दैट अ चाइल्ड कम्स आउट फ्रॉम द वूम्ब ऑफ मदर मदर विथ अ डेकोरेटेड फार्म. सो दिस इज दिव्य कृष्ण ट्रांसडेंटल वर्ड जन्म कर्मम चमे दिव्यम टी दिव्य कृष्ण कम्स अपियर्स इन दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड इट इज ट्रांसडेंटल एंड एज इन भगवद गीता डिस्क्राइब दैट इफ एनी वन सिंपली अंडरस्टैंड द नेचर मिस्ट्री ऑफ कृष्ण जन्म एंड हिज एक्टिविटी कर्म immediately that person become eligible, that person become qualified to enter the spiritual planet. Janm karma chame divyam evam yo veti tattvata tyaktva deham punar janma naiti mameti surjuna. That person after quitting this material body, this is the result of understanding the mystery of janm and karma of Krishna. After quitting his body, that person becomes completely free from repeated cycle of birth and death. Janma karma chame divyam evam yoti tattva deham punar janma. There are no question of punar janma. That person becomes completely free from repeated cycle of birth and death, and he becomes qualified enough, eligible to enter Mam Eti. He comes to the Vaikuntha planet, spiritual planet, he reaches me. So Christian master maybe should try to understand the mystery. Janma karma chame divyam. Krishna janma appearance and his activities they are performed on the spiritual platform, transcendental, for their divine. हरे कृष्ण श्रील प्रभुपाद की श्री श्री कृष्ण जन्माष्टमी की जय.